Hey, welcome back guys to JCap, Playz. So in the last video, we fought Muhammad as Ifrit and the Phoenix combined, and it was amazing. And now just going on with the main quest. I don't think there was any side quests available yet. Yeah, no, we just got back. We're here now. But yo, check this out. We've got Muhammad's abilities. And this one is incredible. Just for the circle button, I can literally unleash Mega Flare. Like, what? Yes, please. now, at 2300 ability points right now, I'm actually gonna save up for the massive beam of the Giga Flare. So, I'm not that far away, you know, less than 400 ability points away. So, I'm gonna hold off on that one. But I am gonna equip Bahamut's abilities now and replace. Yeah, but I'm gonna have to go with Titans and go Bahamut on this one. So, Impulse, that one's pretty cool. And Fire Breath, yeah, I like that one too. But man, I cannot wait to start using Bahamut's abilities. This is gonna be crazy, guys. Alright. Yeah, not much else to do right now. Other than the main quests. Oh, sorry. I forgot. While I'm here, I'm gonna check at the Wall of Memories. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, oh, then you realize Joe was here.
It will take time to come to terms with everything that happened in the Dominion. But time is the one thing we always seem to lack.
Mm. And I'm stuck. Okay. Okay, so a word from Theodore there. Some supplies from Karen.
Did you see the pair that
got goods?
For not leaving me in the Dominion. If you hadn't come back, I might still be stuck there. I told Nan we flew back on the Phoenix. She walloped me for telling fibs. Can you tell her it was the truth, Clive?
Still alive, are you?
Coin purse weighing you down? It'd better I'll be here.
Come again. Or don't. I'm not much bothered either way.
Trouble with your gear, or what do you want?
Oh, Thursday.
Struggling, struggling, so spirit still, unanswered call, a prayer.
Cool. We're getting like a God of War 3 effect here.
Goodness, save us.
Might be hard now, there's only one.
Remember in that game when Kratos was killing all the gods of Olympus? He started to affect the world. And now that we've destroyed most of the Mother Crystals, with only one remaining, things are changing. But it also could be Ultima's plan as well. But let's find out. Let me check the hunt board real quick. Nice, we got some new ones. So I gotta find these guys. Oh, this guy's a bastard. He was tough. 10 of clubs. Okay, rank B is not bad. Oof, an A. The Magath brothers. Wow. Oof, and another S. Alright, so we got some challenges here. Oh, maybe some more donations.
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper. Your benefactors are a generous lot.
Mm-hmm.
Here you are. Come again. I may have more for you.
What's this medallion about? Not bad. God, I just want to try the Mega Flare already.
Otto, how fares the realm?
The realm? Oh, she's just fine. As long as you look past the fact storms out mother crystals and the skies are a roiling cesspit. And Gav, who's with your uncle in the Free Cities, helping Mid with her project? Sent an owl their way the moment the winds turned foul. Still waiting on the reply, though. Do you have any good news? Well, that depends on your definition of good. All right, fine. What do you suggest we do? Oh, no, I'm just a messenger. I'll leave the scheme until those more suited to the task. Could be that Lady Vivian and Old Tones have their own thoughts on the current state of things. Could be that they don't. It certainly can't hurt to ask. I suppose not.
How is it that every one of your little excursions presages some inexplicable catastrophe? Not that you are to blame for the Dominion's fate. No one could have predicted the actions of the Crown Prince.
I'm sorry I couldn't save your home.
My countrymen are stronger than you think. A few toppled clock towers won't break their spirits. They'll be back on their feet in no time.
I hope so.
Look at us. Bluer than a pair of bog crabs. Tempting though it may be, sulking will not help us find a solution to this mess.
You believe there's one to be found?
I don't know. But I am certain we're more likely to find it if we first examine the facts.
Oh, story time.
Beneath these darkened skies, Fear and confusion reign over Valisthea. Oh, the lands around the fallen mother crystals had already begun to wilt for want of ether. But not like this. Crystals that filled wells and fueled furnaces. Now nothing but pretty shards of rock. And those that hang from the people's necks cast nary a glimmer of light to keep the dark at bay. It is only a matter of time before the common folk convince themselves that the end of days is upon us. Yet I fear a swift end is more than we can hope for. While most of the world thirsts for ether, the remainder drowns in it, spawning Akashic in droves, and amidst the hordes of mindless beasts, with magics as like to fail as function, even the strongest nation would falter. Rosaria and the Iron Kingdom teeter on the brink of collapse, while the tragedy in Twinside has all but paralyzed the Holy Empire. Dalmechia fares little better. Rumor has it the ministers fled the capital after the fall of Drake's Fang, leaving their beloved republic to crumble. Walud, meanwhile, moves in earnest. The Einherjar has been sighted off Storm. The world, in short, is in chaos. It would seem our civilization was nothing but a castle of sand, to be washed away at the whim of the waves.
A castle of sand.
Not my best flourish, but it seemed fitting. The reports I've received are considerably more blunt in their appraisal. Without the protection of their nations, it will fall to the people to defend themselves against those who would take what is theirs.
Which is only ever going to end one way.
Defending a farmhouse against a band of chocobo thieves is one thing, but pitchforks and palisades will do little to stall an army's advance. Should the King of Walu deign to invade, there would be none to stop him.
None but us. About the skies.
Is there anything you don't know, Lawsman?
It doesn't take a court astrologer to argue the obvious. As for what has disturbed the heavens, that, I believe, is a question the Fallen might be better placed to answer than I. And on the sixth day, did the gods tear the sun from the firmament, visiting darkness upon their prideful sons and daughters?
I don't remember that Bible verse.
But I dare say you remember your childhood lessons on the sins of Zemeckis only too well.
You think they're connected? Daltimore's one of the gods responsible.
Well, he has certainly exhibited powers that we mortals would associate with the divine.
There is nothing divine about him.
But he wouldn't be the first god of whom that could be said, now would he? Yet for all the fairy tales that tell of the sins, there is almost nothing in the way of actual historical accounts. Had I the journal of Moss the Chronicler, I may have been able to tell you more, but alas, I fear all remaining copies have been lost to time. You will forgive me, I hope?
Certainly not. Because there is nothing to forgive. Even without this journal, you provided us ample wisdom. And we will always be grateful for it. Perhaps Otto will be more inclined to share his thoughts when he hears what the others had to say.
Seems the hideaway is that matter.
Oh, there's Jill.
Clive, we have a problem.
Only one. That'll be a first.
It would. Actually, there are three. We had as many owls arrive while you were at the shelves. Martha's got a cache at her gates and talk of monsters roaming the hills outside of Northreach has put the wind up Isabel and Erlon.
And don't forget Dalimil. Lubor says the village was raided by bandits.
When it rains,
it pours.
It fucking pours. The Curse Breakers are spread thin, taking stock of the damage in the Dominion. And even if I could get word to all of them, I doubt they'd get here in time to make any real difference. Which means there's only two people who care, Jill and I.
Let them know we're on our way.
Okay, time to help out the kingdom. Trees. What happened here? Holy.
Poor bastard. Couldn't run because of the weight of his load. Still, better a branded than one of us.
Fucking thieving bastards.
If life hadn't been hard enough around here since the fang fell.
If you're wondering why Dalimil's in such a sorry state, you can blame the bandits. Them and the mercenaries who are guarding the gates. Though I can hardly fault them for running. Fighting would have meant death. Did for more than a few.
A shock. Why would anyone do such a thing?
Appears much more formidable than your uncle. Should I be worried?
You haven't been introduced.
Jill, Clive has told me much about you.
All lies, I'm sure.
Your Stolas said that Dalimil has a bandit problem.
Indeed. Although, you're a little late. They left with our food and guild days ago.
Any idea where they went?
The desert's a big place. Your guess is as good as mine. But the fact is, I have more immediate concerns.
What did you say to me? What did you say?
Ah, as if by magic. Let's just say we've yet to reach a consensus about how to solve Dalimil's little problem.
Mm.
And at this rate, it won't be the actions of the bandits which prove to be our undoing. It will be our own. I've tried reasoning with the dissenting parties, but even the desert hare has limits.
Perhaps we could talk to them.
What makes you think they'll listen to us?
What makes you think they won't?
She makes a fair point, Sid. And you won't have wasted much of your precious time if you fail. They're just across the courtyard.
Suppose suppose we just follow the shouting.
You wouldn't talk like that if it had been your men whose throats were slit. Blood for blood, it's the only way. We hire mercenaries and have them mount the bandits' heads on our walls as a lesson to the rest.
And what happens when those mercenaries are slaughtered like your men? Are you going to hire more? We're better off using that coin to buy food and supplies. If we hire mercenaries, the only thing we're buying is the bandits' ire. And you cannot fill empty bellies with that. Do you hear me?
But what happens when they come back? Maybe it'll be your throat that's slit.
That's enough. Both of you. Any more of this and I'll throw you out myself. Come back when you're ready to talk like adults.
Victor. What's he doing here?
Sid, and Lady Jill, what brings you here?
I was about to ask you the same thing.
Costness is in chaos, and the markets have all but ceased to operate. The Briar's Kiss here in Dalamil is the only place I can reliably obtain supplies. I was here to do just that when Master Lubor told me of his troubles. He thought I might be able to talk some sense into these fools. But if you're here, I suppose his patience must be waning.
Who are those people?
Those were the thorns in Lubor's side. And the reason this place might be headed the same way as Costness. These accursed skies. The darkness is enough to drive a man to madness. Or an entire city, for that matter.
We're still working on the skies. But in the meantime, perhaps we can find a solution to Dalamil's problems.
I hope so. For all our sakes.
So, you see my predicament?
What I saw was a room full of people who were angry and afraid. And with good reason by the sound of it. But if left to smolder, that anger and fear could set the entire town alight.
My thoughts exactly. Ugh, what to do? Both sides wish to protect their homes and livelihoods, if only they could agree on how. But as long as they are divided, we are vulnerable.
And if there's one thing bandits like, it's an easy target.
What would Sid the Outlaw suggest?
Well, if it were my namesake, he'd let them choose for themselves and be on hand to pick up the pieces when it all went wrong.
That sounds like a recipe for disaster.
A recipe for disaster is precisely what it is. Perhaps that realization would be enough to make them question the ingredients. While it's plain neither Conrad nor Natalie will countenance the other's proposal, it may still be possible to make them doubt their own. Before presenting them with a third option.
And that would be?
To pool our resources and save the city ourselves. Why fight each other?
When all that fear and anger can be directed at the bandits.
It appears we have a plan of action. Victor, pay Conrad a visit. See if you can't convince him of his folly. I'll speak with Natalie.
As you wish.
Your faces are not well known in this town. That may prove useful. Don't worry, Victor and I will do most of the talking. You need only play along.
play along.
What he means to say is yes.
Picture it, comrade. Your own city guard. With you as captain. Ah, here she is. The Lady of the Spear herself. Conrad, may I introduce you to Jane?
Jane.
Commander of the Red Wings. The oldest mercenary guild in the Free Cities.
Even there, she wears blue.
A pleasure, my lady.
The pleasure is all mine.
As I told you, I summoned the commander here from Canberra to inquire about a contract.
Victor says you told him no. That there aren't any men left to hire. Is that true?
True as the crystals cracked. Nobles came and claimed every last one worth his salt. And not just from us Red Wings. You know of the 7 high houses? There must be 20 swords assigned each one. Granted, we have a few boys left. If it's boys you're looking for.
Well, Conrad, are you saying that Dalham's finest cannot defend this town better than a gaggle of unblooded striplings? That a band of beardless youths could better avenge the deaths of your brave men than you yourselves?
Absolutely not. We'll show those bastards who they're dealing with.
I can't believe that actually worked.
Conrad's not what you called the brightest candle in the crypt. And there's a reason why I had you do the talking and not Sid. Well played, my lady.
Possible to buy something. Ah, here he is now. Natalie, allow me to introduce Lord Underhill,
Underhill.
Of Grandelar's prestigious League of Merchants.
Is he Frodo Baggins now?
Lord Underhill, at your service.
Underhill?
I was just telling the good lady of our conversation, my lord, and how you were lamenting the state of the capital stores.
Lubor says that not only are the granaries almost empty, but that war and the blight mean this season's harvest won't be enough to fill them for winter.
Indeed, certainly that is the case. The nobles in the capital are buying up the city's stocks of barley and wine, driving the prices higher than most commoners can afford. It is only a matter of time before the peasants revolt.
It is worse than I thought. If what Lord Underhill says is true, I fear we have little hope of supplementing our stores, meager though they regrettably are. And while I applaud your endeavors to dissuade our more bellicose citizens from seeking vengeance, I sense Conrad is not wrong in his assessment of the bandits' likely return. Which means that now, more than ever, we will need to secure what little we still have. Food, weapons, herbs, everything. If our humble town is to endure not only this hardship, but those that are certain to follow, we must stand united.
All right. If it will help to protect my home, I'll do it. But you needn't have gone through this charade.
She's a smart one.
Thank you, Clive. Your performance was nothing if not workmanlike.
She saw right through it.
I didn't say it was good, merely that it produced the desired effect. Now, my scouts should be returning shortly. Meet me back at the Briar's Kiss, and we shall see what we face.
convinced our roles in this ruse were entirely necessary.
I don't know. Conrad seemed quite taken with you.
But I would not see anything.
Mummy, I'm scared.
My shop. Oh, I'm ruined.
Good news, Sid. Both Conrad and Natalie have somewhat gracefully accepted their new roles. With time, they may even learn to.
Time no longer appears to be the luxury it was before lunch.
I take it your scouts found the bandits.
Technically, it would be the bandits who found my scouts. It appears they march for Dalamil as we speak. All of them.
You're not serious.
They don't just want food, they want the whole damn town.
I have a favor to ask. I'm told the bandits march in two groups, one from the south and one from the desert, in a move doubtless intended to stretch our already gossamer-thin defenses.
Very well. Jill and I will meet those from the desert. But what of the rest?
The rest, my friend, the city shall fight. Together. Mistakes, I concede, are high. But if this does not unite Dalamil, nothing will.
That is a lot of faith to put into those who had their hands around each other's throats but a moment ago.
Then it will be for us to see that their hands are kept occupied. And I do mean us.
I thought you might say that.
We'll hold them off for as long as we can.
And we will do the same.
Okay, finally some action. Oh yeah.
No women folk have come to bug us.
I'll take that one.
He's all yours.
He wants it. I guess all of you.
Oh!
There's more!
Nice try.
Over here!
The townspeople. Could they have held out?
I don't hear any fighting. What do you think?
But we should hurry.
I owe you an apology. You did well out there. The inn would have been lost had you not held the line.
Without you, there would have been no line to hold. You saved us, comrade. You saved Alamil.
We all saved Alamil. Conrad seems to have had a change of heart.
I'd say they both have.
I take it from your presence that our visitors from the desert won't be joining us either.
Pity. The plan worked, Cid. Granted, it only took an army of bloodthirsty bandits at our gate.
Come now, Victor. Why quibble over the details? We are united, and that is all that matters. As for you, Cid, you fight considerably better than you act.
I'll take that as a compliment.
Nice, one down, two to go. Though. Impulse. Oops. It's gonna be one of them. It's gonna be Impulse. Area. Damn. Carnage is everywhere.
You, Clive. Jill?
Otto said you'd been attacked by a Kashyyyk. What exactly happened here?
Those skies are what happened. Not long after they fell dark, we had our first visit. There were hundreds of them. Tried to storm the hill. Only a handful made it up here, but that was more than enough. The rest are still down there now. And while we have a few willing fighters holding them back, they're sorely outnumbered. What do you think, Clive?
That we join the fight.
I thought you'd never offer. Now, where I need you is the Fallen Gate. That's where the fighting is fiercest. Let the men know you've come to help. Something tells me they'll be pleased to see you.
We're on our way.
All right, let's do this.
Do you think there were as many as Martha says?
More.
Mm-hmm. Man, come on, move your asses.
You don't think they've abandoned us, do you?
Faster!
Damn it. No, that wasn't very far.
Wounded.
We deal with the Akashic first.
Come to rob this place.
You are mistaken, my Lord Rosfield. We're here by Madame Martha's leave.
How do you know my name?
Forgive me, my lord. There wasn't time for introductions. We're with the Guardians of the Flame.
Waitsmen. But how did you come to be here? Where is your commander?
Sir Wade left earlier with a scouting party to find out where the Akashic were coming from.
Did he? Take your wounded back to the inn. Martha will see you're looked after. We'll join you anon.
And to think you took them for thieves. A fine reward for holding off the horde, that is.
When did Wade and his men arrive?
Not long after Rosalith fell. The Guardians asked me to shelter some of them that had lost their homes. They were making ready to leave just as the skies turned, and we agreed it was best we stuck together.
Martha! Trouble! The scouting party's almost at the lift. They got a pack of Akashic snapping at their heels! And they got wounded with them! They're not gonna make it!
Damn it all!
We'll worry about them, Martha.
You look after everyone here. If any can still fight, send them to the lift.
I will. You two be safe now.
Wait.
Squire, I need you to get those who can still walk up the lift to Martha's. But what about... I didn't ask, Oscar. Sir
Wade.
Lord Rossfield, if you aren't a sight for sore eyes.
Martha seemed to think you might need some help. And by the looks of it...
We thought we could sneak by them. But we didn't know there would be so many. How could we have?
Behind you!
Oh, one of these ones again.
Damn it! We need to get the injured to safety.
Do you think we can hold them off?
We could certainly try. Are you with us, Sir Wade?
Always.
Then let's do our duty. Get him!
Right now. Let's go.
Is anyone hurt?
I don't think so.
And yet again, you've pulled me from the flames. It's just a pity I keep walking into them.
You've never been one to shy away from danger, Sir Wade. Like any shield worthy of the name.
I see you're all in one piece.
Martha!
Is something wrong?
The lookout saw smoke coming from down Eastpool way. Too thick to be a hearth.
A second horde.
Feel like finishing the job.
Always.
Jill and I will make for Eastpool. You'll need to move the engine without us.
Don't you worry about them.
The moment my men are safe, I'll follow. Good luck.
For the rest.
Ah!
We have to slow them down. Martha and the others won't be ready.
Chocobos.
Apologies, my lord. Did I miss anything?
Only the first round to wait. Shall we? Anymore?
No. I think that was the last of them.
But it won't be long before the next lot arrive.
Then we make for Martha's while we can.
What did you find out there?
Same as Sir Wade. Scores of Akashic.
Well, wherever they came from, they're gone now. Our lookouts say the lowlands are clear. Hopefully we'll have enough time to lick our wounds.
How many of your men were injured?
Damn sight less than if you hadn't turned up. Thank you.
It was a hard-fought victory. But as long as the skies remain dark, I fear the Akashic's numbers are only going to rise.
It's not a matter of if the Horde will be back, but when. And whether that's sooner or later, we'll need to be ready. The inn here affords a good view of the land, and is easily defendable. I'd like to make this one of our outposts.
What do you say, Martha? You'd have more men to guard the rest.
Well, when you put it like that, of course they can stay.
Someone I'd like you to meet. Oscar, over here.
It is an honor to make your acquaintance, Lord Rossfield. I am Oscar. Oscar of House Murdoch.
Murdoch? I wasn't aware the Lord Commander had children.
Oh, he didn't. Mm. But his brother, my father, did. I am Sir Rodney's nephew.
Well, go on then. It's not for me to ask him.
Yes, so wait. If it pleased you, my Lord Marquis, might you take me as your squire? I would learn the duties of a shield from the finest.
I'm sorry to disappoint you, Oscar. But I am a shield no longer, nor was I ever the finest. And spending time in the company of an outlaw hardly seems a fitting education for one aspiring to take his oaths.
My Aunt Hannah once told me that a man is not defined by his title, but what he does in its name. You have accomplished much since taking on the mantle of Cid, winning no little honor in so doing. And I would sooner serve under an honorable outlaw than an unworthy shield.
Yeah.
Not that Sir Wade and the other guardians are... I mean to say that...
It's all right. We know what you mean. There is only so much the boy can learn from me, my lord.
But a squire...
Would that really be so bad? You were a squire once.
I don't know.
And I'm certain Sir Rodney would approve.
Could this be Ultima? Plotting and planning?
Know that I'll show you as much leniency as your uncle showed me.
I would not have it any other way.
Oh man, this is awkward.
I will not let you down, Lord Rossfield. You or my uncle.
We shall be staying here for the time being, and not just for the ale. I'll have one of my men escort Oscar to Benemir once he's said his farewells.
All right, get this last one here.
Unless we find Isabel.
I saw it with my own eyes. The whole of Oriflame under a flood.
Oh.
Yeah. We're next.
She's down there.
Sightings of strange creatures, I understand.
With the blue eyes. Yes. Like a Kashyyyk, but different. They've taken so many. I've lost count.
A Kashyyyk, but different.
Ultimus Thralls. And what of your mistress? Is she here?
Oh, no. She went to the garrison to ask what they were planning on doing about all this.
Then we'll look for her there.
Thank you.
could leave. The two soldiers were carrying.
Madame, please!
Half the garrison's been slaughtered by those things. We lost the captain this very morning.
We've tried requesting reinforcements, but there's been no word from the capital or the Dominion in days! What more would you have us do?
I would have you do your duty. Those at the Vale look to me for protection. Protect them I shall, because they are my charges and that is my duty. In case you have forgotten, the people of this town are your charges. But more than that, they are your people. Your sisters, your brothers, your lovers. So you have a choice. Lay down your sword and watch as they are slaughtered, or take it up and do what is right.
She speaks the truth, you know. This here, it's all we have. It's all that's left.
What we have left is our lives! Do you really want us to lose them as well?
Not if we don't ask to. Look, there's a cask under the captain's bunk. Let's talk about this over a drink, eh?
I'm listening.
I'll have a word with her.
To arrive so quickly, and sought to take matters into my own hands.
It was a noble effort, but I thought you might still need some support.
I like you to consider my needs. What we need to consider is where the creatures came from. The way the survivors speak of them, one would think they appeared out of thin air. And perhaps they did. It's hard to know what to believe these days.
We'll talk to the survivors. You're a pikeman, yes? What happened?
I've got family and more. I heard the flood was spreading, so I went to see if they were all right. In the back of them glowing things found me in the meadow. I ran for my life. I never did get to the village.
Leave that to us.
My family! They're still in the camp.
That thing?
Did you see the creatures that attacked you?
Creatures? They came out of nowhere. They went for Josie first, then me, and then they were just gone.
Do you remember where you were?
On the road from Oriflam. We just passed Moor when... Where's my Joseph?
It's all right. Just rest now. At least we have an idea of where the thralls might be now. We should head for Moor.
Was all they could do to escape. They just left the bodies there in the flood.
Faster!
see them. With me.
We've done what we can for the time being.
I wish you'd let Isabel know.
You have the town's thanks.
Don't thank us yet.
Most of the men to remain at their posts, for now at least.
Hearing that the Dane would look kindly on any man who committed himself to the task certainly didn't hurt. It's not the most selfish of motives, I'll admit, but whatever it takes, eh? Now me, I never needed convincing. I became a soldier to protect the people I love. The people I love include the ones standing before me.
Handsome and chivalrous.
Now, if you don't mind, I have sent you to post. My lady.
Lest you wonder, I'm not foolish enough to believe that this has solved all of my problems. But it has solved one, and that's one fewer than I had this morning. Thank you again, Clive.
Thank you.
seem to have things under control. For now, at least. Let's go and put Otto's mind at rest.
So many.
Those things I said before.
You needn't fret. The creatures have been dealt with.
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper. Your benefactors are a generous lot.
Oh, nice.
All yours.
Got 1,500 ability points. That's awesome.
Come again.
Ooh, 24 hundo.
Oh, yeah.
I was wondering when you turn up. Hello, small our friends thanking you for your timely intervention. How is it you always manage to arrive at just the right moment?
Luck, I suppose. Any word on the rest of the realm?
Let's see. Storm's still crying out from other crystals. The nations are still in chaos. And the skies are still the colour of a kick in the kidneys 2 days old. So...
Right.
Clive, we knew this was going to happen. Well, not the bleeding skies part. But you take my point. Now's not the time to second guess yourself. Now's the time to visit the infirmary. Tyre says your brother's awake.
Thank you, Otto.
Joshua, oh, there's Dion still alive, that's good.
Not Sylvester, but Olivier, who served as Ultima's pup. And when Dion learned of this, he sought to slay the fiend. Only for his father to take the spear that would have freed him. Enough to drive a man to madness.
Small wonder he hasn't stirred. Afraid to wake.
Had I but reached out to him soon, warned him of the threat Ultima posed. But now, both an empire and her prince lie broken.
Joshua, a What do you know of Ultima?
Very little, I'm afraid. Despite my best efforts. 18 years ago, as I lay buried beneath the rubble of Phoenix Gate, it was not death who came for me, but a lover. And it was while in my rescuer's care, I first heard of Ultima. I've been chasing his shadow ever since. Ultima is driven by some deep, dark purpose, and for whatever reason, it would seem you are crucial to his designs. He will stop at nothing to have you, even if that means toppling an empire.
Why me? What possible use could I be to such a creature?
That is one of many answers that have eluded me. Yet, I am certain of this. It is not mere chance. You have been chosen for a reason. All dominants carry within them the might of an icon. Nigh limitless power that is at once acutely limited. I wield fire, and only fire.
And I only ice. 8 wardens for 8 elements.
But he's the ninth.
Jew. Blythe.
You are different. You're special. Your abilities begin with the flames of Ifrit. They do not end there. The fact Ifrit can even exist goes against everything we thought we knew of dominance. Perhaps Ultima has been waiting for one such as you, whose potential is truly limitless.
I've encountered that thing several times now. If it or he, as you say, needs me, why hasn't he claimed me as he did the boy?
Were I to hazard a guess, I'd say the two of you are somehow incompatible. His mind's not properly attuned to your body.
His mind?
Awareness, spirit, call it what you wish. But I believe Ultima to be an embodiment of the concept. It is why I struggle and fail to contain him here inside me.
Sorry. Inside you?
With every setting sun, I feel my strength wane. And though the Phoenix's flames mend the prison I have made for Ultima, they do so at a cost. We must find the means to bring an end to him before I make my own.
What were you thinking?
It was that or let him take Clive. And I've always had a soft spot for him.
That doesn't mean you should sacrifice yourself to save me.
Oof.
Joshua. Clive, it's Gav. There's an army of Akashic at the gates of Canver.
Well, I guess it's time to fight again.
Well, what's the short of it?
Tyre told you. The capital of the Free Cities is under siege by an army of monstrosities. City Guard are doing their best to stem the tide, but numbers ain't on their side.
What of Lord Byron and Mid? Were they able to escape?
No. But they're all right for now. They're hiding with Gav at midship.
We have to get them out of there.
Then we shall. Otto, prepare a Stolas. Tell Gav to stay exactly where he is.
Understood.
Vivian. What's the swiftest route to the Free Cities?
That sounds like a question for the map. Look here. This way, through Tabor, should provide the least trouble.
Good.
What a coincidence. Tabor is exactly where I'm bound.
Joshua, Bed is where you should be bound. You don't think I told him the exact same thing?
Were Tyre not such a talented healer, I would surely have been inclined to agree. But I'm
thanks to her ministrations, I feel I may safely rejoin my attendant, who is to wait for me in Tabor if we became separate.
All right, we travel together.
Clive.
If he stays close to me, he'll be fine.
Thank you.
Oh, road trip with my bro.
My attendant was with me in the Dominion before I arrived. She would have watched the battle unfold and witnessed its outcome. I trust you'll be waiting for me in Tabor, where I can finally introduce you.
Ty is right. Your brother is in no condition to travel. That's all I'll say on the matter. Mid, Gav, and your uncle we should be thinking about now. You know how I feel about this, but your brother's stubbornness knows no bounds. I'm starting to think it runs in the family.
Yeah, it sure does. Holy side quest, Batman. Alright guys, I think that's gonna do it for this episode. I'll touch back and run through the side quests in the next one. Thanks for tuning in. If you like what you saw, please like, share, and subscribe. Peace.